The add torque function is similar to add force, but the force works by rotating the game object around a defined axis. Add torque has two components, the second being optional. The first is a vector that defines the axis around which the torque will be applied, and the magnitude of the torque applied. In this example, our power cube has this script attached. We are using the add torque function and specifying that transform.up, the local up direction of the object, will be the axis to add torque to. Because Unity uses the left-hand screw rule, torque will be added around this axis as shown in this diagram. Try for yourself by making a thumbs up gesture with your left hand. Then imagine that the torque is added in the direction that your fingers are curled into your palm. Here, we are simply multiplying by the variable h, which is a variable used to get input from the horizontal axis, multiplied by the amount variable over time. On the other add torque line, we are applying it to the transform.right axis, the local x-axis of the object. Let's see this in action. When I press the horizontal keys, I can apply torque, and as you can see, once the torque is applied and I let go of the key, the inertia will keep going because this is part of the physics simulation. Similarly, I can apply it to the x-axis, and because this is local, it will spin around that axis depending on where it happens to be. You should also bear in mind that the angular drag component of the rigid body will define how effective the torque is when applied to the object. For example, I can apply a lot of torque around this axis, leave it running under inertia, but when I increase angular drag, it becomes a lot harder to get that object moving because of the angular drag. Whereas if we have no angular drag, it's easy to keep the object spinning in a particular direction because there's very little inertia slowing it down. The second parameter is an optional parameter used to affect the type of force that's going to be applied. If this is left out, it will default to the type force. This is used for continuous changes that are affected by mass. Acceleration is for continuous changes that aren't affected by mass. Impulse is for an instant change that is affected by mass, and velocity change is for an instant change that isn't affected by mass. Let's see the effect of adding this to our script. Now, when rotating the cube using add torque, when I press the opposite key to apply torque in the other direction, it responds far more quickly. So it's worth always considering the type of force that you're applying when adding torque.